So the tutorial is not going as planned today. So first, this was completely out of focus because it's face detection and I put my face in the background as well and I was focusing on that. Secondly, I was recording my tutorial and as you can see on my Instagram story, my computer crashed. So take two, we're not gonna get disappointed, we're just gonna do this. Hey, what's up ladies and gentlemen, I'm Ignace Aleya and today it's another Filmmaking Friday. In today's Filmmaking Friday, we're going to see something very exciting and very easy to do, which is also important. And as Halloween is around the corner, we have been doing a ton of Halloween effects in Adobe After Effects. And today's tutorial is not gonna be anything different. We're going to see how to create vampire teeth just like you saw in the preview. They really look very cool and they're super simple to create. But before we start with the tutorial, I would like to say something very quick and hopefully you don't mind. But yeah, first of all, it's not that easy for me to sit up straight here right now. It kind of hurts a lot because last week I was driving with the Meepo board, which is an electronic skateboard, and it was night, so I was coming home. It's not that long of a distance and I was driving in the dark, so I didn't see anything. I don't have any lights on that skateboard, which I should have, so this is entirely my fault and my responsibility, and I wasn't being so safe. But I was thinking that I should slow down a little bit, which I did, because I didn't see what was in front of me, and all of a sudden my wheels got stuck in a hole and I fell off my skateboard and I crushed my rib on the floor. And yeah, ever since it's been very difficult to do anything on this computer because I have to sit all the time and it really kind of hurts me a lot. But yeah, we gotta do this. It's a Filmmaking Friday, so we are going to do this. But that being said, I want to say something else as well, and it's not that I want to go on and ramble, but as you, my audience, you already know that we are working with a website called toleratedcinematics.com where we offer templates and so on. But we're actually already working in the background on something entirely new, a new platform for any digital creator. And it's actually something that we want to build in an entire community for any digital creator, not only for templates, but also for courses and much more than that. Anything you can think of that could improve a digital creator's workflow, that's what we're going to try and put into that website. Anyway. Currently, our website is called Tolerated Cinematics, and we're going to entirely rebrand that website also with a new name called CreatorGalaxy.com, because that name, it's a little bit more to the point on what it's doing. Tolerated Cinematics is also really hard to spell, so we thought of changing that. So my first question would be, do you like the name? I hope you'll like the name. All the branding is also going to be done in some kind of space style, which I really enjoy doing. It's one of my favorite effects to be playing around with. I'm just so curious about space. It attracts me a lot. It's such a beautiful thing that we have no grasp on. So anyway, I'm telling you this because we need your help. If you are a graphic designer or a logo designer, or you know someone that might be, and you want to help out with Creator Galaxy, we are breaking our head on a new logo. We want the logo that really kind of has a nicely thought through kind of logo design that also speaks about the galaxy, about the creator. If you have any idea, if you want to give it a go, please do so and help us out. And then email us at hello@toleratedcinematics.com. I will put the email in the description below. I'm sure we could work out something great together and have a nice collaboration. All right, so I just said everything that I wanted to say. Without further ado, let's jump into the tutorial. It's been taking too long. And yeah, I don't like to talk too much before I start on the tutorial, which I'm still doing right now and I will continue doing right now if I don't stop. So let's jump into it. All right, so here we are in Adobe After Effects, and yeah, right here you see the preview of the final result where I have these vampire teeth, and yeah, I could go for a vampire, I guess. Looks pretty badass. All right, so what I will do is I'll give you the footage of me so you can follow along with this tutorial using the exact same footage as I am. I will put a link in the description so you can go and download that. And apart from that, we'll get started. So we'll right click over here in our project manager and import the footage. So this is the footage, and as you can see, it's an image sequence. The reason why is because we need to track it, and that's the only easier way to work with Mocha. So what you'll do is click on the first image, make sure that you have PNG sequence checked on, and then you click import, and that should import an image sequence, which now is a video. If you double click on that, there you go. Ooh, scary. So we'll go and right click here and go into interpret footage main, and we want to change the assume this frame rate from 30 or whatever you have to 25, because that's the actual frame rate this video was shot on. We'll click OK,
And now we can drag this into a new composition. So we'll drag it over here. And then we want to play it through, or we want to click on it, go to animation, track in Mocha AE. That's going to open up Mocha, which is a software that is included in your Adobe subscription. And this is just a very, very powerful tracking tool or software that you can use. So we'll click OK once you have that open. And then we want to kind of scrub through a position where my teeth are very visible, and we could say like, okay, here I want to put in my vampire teeth. So what we'll do is go over here and this tool, create X-spline layer tool. If we click on that, we want to click on maybe the left part first. And yeah, I do have these kind of knots because I was kind of using Invisalign to straighten my teeth. So it's still on there. So yeah, kind of looks more like a vampire. I'm completely in my role. Okay, so we're going to click on a few details here and try to get as much detail as you can. Of course, if you want to do this perfectly, would be better if you have some kind of stains on your teeth, or just like use a pen to put some dots. But I didn't do that because I didn't know how healthy that would be to put something in my mouth. And forget what I said. That's not what she said. Okay, so I'm going to right click once I've done my selection, and I will track backwards. Okay. So once you start losing your track in the beginning, it doesn't really matter. Go back to that point. You will see that with a green dot over here. And then you want to track forward. So the idea here is to track the left top teeth, then the right top teeth, and then the left bottom and the right bottom. So in total, you will have to redo this process 4 times. Okay, we can stop here. Export the tracking data by clicking on this button, and then format, we want to use After Effects, Corner Pin, Supports, Motion, Blur, and so on. So click this one and copy to clipboard. Let's go back to After Effects. Right click and create a new null object. So in this new null object, we're actually going to rename it to Left Top Teeth. And there we go. Go to the beginning of your timeline, click on that layer, Control V to paste your keyframes. And if you press U on the keyboard, you'll see that it worked. So, and there we go. Perfect. So now what you want to do is jump back into Mocha. Go over here to your layers and delete the layer over here. Go back to your spline tool, but first find a location, maybe over here, and then click on your X-spline tool. Now we're going to track this part. And we're gonna track backward. So in this tutorial, I'll just show you the top teeth because it's basically the same for the bottom teeth. So the workflow is exactly the same. So I wouldn't know why you wouldn't succeed in doing that. And otherwise, I'm sorry for letting you down. Okay, so of course you will lose data here because your mouth closes and stuff, but that doesn't matter because we only want to have the teeth when the mouth is open and we wanna animate them on, so that's perfect. So we're going to export our tracking data again, copy to clipboard, go back to After Effects. And what you can do is create a new null object. So there we go, null object, and rename it to track right top key. Go back to the beginning of your timeline, click on that layer, and Control V to paste the information. So there we have it. Now we should have 2 null objects on our key, on our teeth, which looks perfect. Okay, so now what we want to do is click on our footage, duplicate it. And on the duplicated layer, we want to go for a liquify effect. You can do that by searching here in the effects and presets, or going to distort, I think, liquify. And apply that to your layer. So now let's zoom in a little bit, hold space to move around here. And we want to go into the tools here and the warp tool options, change a brush size to something like 10, maybe increase the pressure to something like 75. And then we go to this tool, the first option here, and we want to kind of draw our teeth. So there we go. You can see what we're doing here. You can also kind of tuck them in a little bit, kind of finalize all the detail. Get your teeth action going. Something like that. Maybe we can also do this teeth here. Bring it down. Okay. And then over here as well. Okay, so the reason I'm doing this with the Liquify tool is because I think it's important to do it with your own teeth instead of working with a different teeth, because your reflections are always different. So now it kind of looks very natural. So once you've done that, click on the layer, go to layer and pre-compose that layer with moving all the attributes in that layer and rename it Teeth Comp. Click OK. And now we want to right click on that composition and go for time freeze the frame. And now very simple, we want to kind of duplicate this layer four times, and then we want to key out every single teeth separately. So we're going to rename this teeth 01, and then if you duplicate it four times. So we're going to uncheck the first three and focus on teeth 01. So this is going to be teeth 01, so what we'll do is zoom in, go to the pen tool and key it out. And even here you can do some final detail, maybe you don't like how you drew it before, so you can leave out some parts and that doesn't really matter that much. And then we want to close it like this, and there we go. So now we have it keyed out, and what you want to do now is just bind this to the top left track. So top left, okay. So now that it's bound to that track, what you want to do is click away, click back on that layer, and maybe go back to the pen tool and click over here, and make some kind of rectangle around it. And then we want to press M on the keyboard to reveal our mask path over here. And then we want to subtract the second mask from the first one. And if we press F on the keyboard, that's going to reveal the feather for that mask. We want to kind of bring it up to something like 14. So we have a nice fade between our teeth, because when it's moving, the lighting conditions will change. We don't want to make it too obvious. So there we go. So now we have our first teeth completely tracked. Now for the second teeth, it's basically the same. We just enable this layer. We go to the pen tool and we key it out. You can also do it with a rectangle over here and then subtract that over here and F. Feather it just a touch, and again bind this to the top left. Now for the third key, teeth. I don't know why I keep saying key. Key is not a teeth, it's teeth. Okay, so we're gonna mask out our key here. No, I'm kidding. It's we're gonna mask out our teeth, and then there we go. The rectangle, subtract, press F, feather. Go here one more time and we're there. So boom boom, cool. And for the top two teeth right here, 3 and 4, we want to bind this to the right top teeth. Okay, cool. So now they're actually tracked in position. They kind of look okay. I do see some kind of issues here with this teeth. So that could mean that I have to retrack this, or we could just start our teeth growing over here. So to grow your teeth, it's also very simple. We go and press M on the keyboard and click on the stopwatch for the first mask. And that's going to do that for each individual teeth. Okay. So now that you've done that, go a few seconds back and then click on the first key. Oh my God, I'm doing it again. The first teeth, and we're going to move this up until it's covering the old and the original teeth. And we also want to do some kind of opacity fade in. So we can also do that with T. And if you press T on the keyboard, we can click on stopwatch for opacity and then press U on the keyboard to reveal all the keyframes again. Move this just a few frames and set it to 0 at the beginning, so that way we have it growing just like this. So pretty cool. So I'm going to copy this opacity preset. So I'm going to hold Control, press C on the keyboard, click on this layer, and then Shift on the top layer, press Control V to paste the opacity to all of the teeth. So there we go. Then for this layer, we're just going to move this up, very simple. This one also, and this one also. Okay, so now we have growing vampire teeth. Awesome. All right, so that's basically it. And to disappear, it's basically copying this keyframe, copying this one, and pasting it over here. Keep doing that. And if you want to make it even crazier, you could go and maybe offset these keyframes and then kind of grow teeth separately, which I don't know why that would happen, but maybe you think that's cool and maybe it is. Maybe it is for your video. First these teeth and then the back teeth, and there we go. So vampire teeth, and then they go away and I close my mouth finally. So there we have the effect. And then basically what I did at the end is I created an adjustment layer. I went for effect color correction and I applied a Lumetri color, and I went to the creative tab and I browsed for a lookup table. And in this case, if you want, you can use one of our LUTs right here, for example, the apocalypse, and just lower the intensity. Also go into the basic correction and lower the saturation like so. And maybe go for something else. And this one is pretty cool. So now we go to Vignette, lower this also. And yeah, there we have it.
Alright, so that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give this video a like. Also, be sure to subscribe to the channel for more and hit the notification bell to get notified when we upload new videos. Apart from that, check out our website, which is soon gonna be another website. But if you buy something from our website, it helps to support this channel. So I hope to see you guys in the next one. Goodbye.